Action research needs people. You can't do a darn thing without people. Because of challenging situations in my life, I didn't have any people to work with in person on my capstone project. So what to do? CLU wants its student researchers to bring stakeholders on board early to help figure out and collaborate on the capstone projects. Great idea, in theory. Since I had no people physically around me to recruit, I decided to reach out to potential stakeholders virtually using messaging, text, email, social media posts, even some phone calls. My capstone was about deepening core values knowledge and making one positive change and aligning time use with those values, all in support of building a flourishing life. I figured people would be excited about the idea of learning more about what was important to them and aligning their lives to match. To effectively make change, you have to first get people's attention, and there's a lot of stuff competing for their attention. Trying to capture stakeholder interest virtually was like I was attempting to flag down drivers on a busy road. I thought these metaphorical drivers / potential stakeholders would be thrilled to pull over for a moment to see what was up. It wasn't happening. Rather depressingly, no one wanted to take the time to pull over and engage with me. The most I got was a few "I'll get back to yous," waving, so to speak, as they drove speedily past. I still had no people. A vast, empty plane, void of humanity, stretched in front of me, and deadlines for papers built upon stakeholder needs, interests, and insights were fast approaching. Giving up on trying to get people's attention, I left the side of the metaphorical road, feeling rather dejected, rejected, and depressed. I felt like my capstone project had been pushed away, labeled as useless. I thought, maybe my project really has no value. Capstone-related papers were now due, and I wrote them not following instructions because I didn't have any stakeholders the way I was supposed to. I like following instructions. I felt like a failure. And I was pretty sure that my capstone was never going to happen. No people, no project. Curiosity sparks interest. Interest gets people in the space with you, and then you can hook them, engage them in a dialogue about how their life can be positively affected by this action research project. You can then bring them on board. If you can't get people curious, if they are too busy to join in, if helping you out, doing you a favor, isn't enough of a reason to participate, what in the world do you do then? It was now, when I was about to throw in the towel, that it rather belatedly occurred to me to reach out for help to my capstone advisor. We reframed the story of the situation. I saw that the potential stakeholders, through their non-response, were giving clear signals that they were too busy to add anything to their lives. They were proving the need for the project. People's busyness underscored the challenge of recruitment for participants in action research, and the fact that I was recruiting virtually just made things even more difficult, as there was no chance for in-person persuasion or cornering. However, if I changed the questions I was asking, maybe the answers would change, and there might still be hope for stakeholder engagement later in the process. While not ideal, this plan would make it possible to continue forward. I reached back out to potential stakeholders with two new questions. I asked if in the future they might be up for joining in the action research itself, and critically, what would I need to do to make that possible? After much nagging and repeated attempts at getting these people's attention, I did successfully gather several responses. The gist of the answers from these potential stakeholders was that they might join for the research portion itself if the length of their needed involvement was short, it didn't take a lot of time daily to do the actions, and it was easy to understand and access the needed information. They also didn't want to hear from me again until just before the go date of the research time. Woohoo! Who was happy? Me! I had maybes. Maybe never looked so good. I knew that these particular people might or might not commit, but thanks to their answers, I also now knew what I had to do to move forward. The glad news that people might be up for joining the action research part last minute gave me hope to act without any guarantees of stakeholder participation. Hope was enough. My papers might not be written to spec, but I could at least now bring this useful knowledge into the formation of the project. By rejecting early participation, the potential stakeholders formed the shape and methodology of my approach. By not participating, they participated. I can now create the home base for a virtual research action project, making everything ready for when people did jump in. I designed and implemented a one-stop shopping webpage on my personal website that had everything needed to understand and participate in the project. There were PDFs to download, surveys to complete, and only once was navigation off the page necessary to go to HelloSign to sign the participant release form. After gathering info virtually, participants would do the reflective exercise in the physical world where and when it suited them. I settled on 10 days as the length of the project and 5 to 10 minutes per day needed to participate, fulfilling the need for a short-term and short-duration experience. I did my best to create instructions on the webpage hub that would not need further clarification. Measurement was done through surveys on the virtual hub and through mini video exit interviews of no more than 15 minutes. 10 days before the start of the action research part of the project, I launched an intensive recruitment sequence with personal email, text, and social media invites to colleagues and friends, as well as posting generally. I ended up with 16 people jumping into my virtual action research project, which I have affectionately turned into the acronym VARP. Amazingly, after the 10 days of action research, my participants showed measurements and positive growth in foundational roots of core values knowledge and time use integration in support of a flourishing life. These positive gains included an increase in core values knowledge, an application of core values to relationship and work, positive health benefits, and changes in schedules to better orient around core values. Here's the kicker. The real obstacle was not the lack of people. It was my opposition to what was occurring, my resistance, that was the actual obstacle. Once I got on board what was happening, then I could do what Bruce Lee famously suggested, be like water. Water can overcome perceived obstacles by wearing down what is in its path, forming new pathways, or incorporating what seems to be in the way into its journey. People are unpredictable. If you find yourself unable to recruit stakeholders, don't despair. Step back, listen to what is really happening, and reach out for guidance by those who have done this before. Utilize obstacles as an inherent part of the change processes. You don't necessarily have to overcome obstacles for change to occur. Instead, like boulders in a river, they can help to shape and direct the flow. Your desire to move forward, to make positive change, has to be bigger, stronger, and more forceful than the challenges and obstacles you face. That's where courage comes from. You can't help but act because you know you have to. The world needs you and your capstone projects. I know you can do it. I wish you all the best and great success as you walk on.